Jessica, we're back, but it looks like you've got a friend with you now.
I do.
And we're going to be doing uncomfortable pet questions. But who do you have with you right now?
I have Kim. She doesn't like it when I video for too long. She gets lonely.
Because she gets too much attention?
She gets a lot of attention.
All right, well, let's get started. Maybe Kim will settle down there a little bit. I see you've got a bed underneath your desk. I see there's actually a bed over there. She's got beds everywhere, doesn't she?
She has a lot of beds. That's for sure.
Okay. So our first question comes from Albert. Albert is in Australia. And
awesome.
That's very cool. He's down under there, but he's got a problem with his house.
Okay.
So I don't know. The problem with the house is there's fleas everywhere. Now, he has two Dalmatians, and there's fleas all through the house, and he wants to know how to get rid of the fleas in the house. It's almost like an infestation. They're biting the family members. What does he do to get rid of fleas in the house?
Okay, first and foremost, we need to take care of your dogs because your dogs have fleas. And that is incredibly uncomfortable. I mean, these little animals, I mean, they serve their purpose in the ecosystem. I get that, but I don't want them on my pet. You don't want them on your pet. And we need to simultaneously get the fleas off of your dogs and out of your home. For me, I don't love using harsh chemicals. I know that chemicals can be detrimental, not only to my health, but very much so to the health of my pet. I try not to use chemicals as much as possible. One thing I will say, and this is kind of a little bit of a tangent, but you'll understand in just a second. One thing I will say is that there are some areas of the world where fleas run rampant. They're just horrible. I get that. But in general, I will say that the healthier your pet is, the less likely fleas, ticks, mosquitoes, heartworms, things like that are going to infiltrate or infect or want to reside in or on your dog, because your dog is super top-notch healthy. So if you're feeding something like kibble to your dog, if they're not in the best health, that can also play a contributing factor. So I would say let's talk more about the health of your pet, but immediately you want to get rid of the fleas. My best suggestion for you is to check out Animalio essential oils, and I will link them in the description below. I'm not affiliated with them. I don't, like, this isn't an affiliate link. I don't make any money off of this. I just happen to really, really love their products. It's veterinary grade essential oils created by a veterinarian, tested by a veterinarian on real animals. They are completely safe for your animals and very effective. So that's what I would do. I would look at the flea balm. I would look at Evict, especially possibly the Away blend. I'll link all of these in the description below. That's what I would look at. We need to simultaneously get the fleas off of your dogs and remove them from your home. So let's not forget about your dogs, because they are definitely being affected just as much as you and your family are. Let's treat everything all at once. And again, let's look at the health of your dogs once you have these fleas taken care of, so this doesn't keep happening.
Jessica, we're here for uncomfortable questions, right?
We are.
I hope you're ready for this one.
Oh, goodness.
This is from Ahmad Patel.
Okay, Ahmad.
He is in, it looks like, Pakistan.
Oh, wow. Okay.
And he's a single guy. He's 22.
Okay.
And he says he was way too embarrassed to ask his vet this question, so he's coming to you with it.
Oh.
He has a puppy, and it's a female puppy.
Okay.
And he understands that females have periods. And he wants to know when his dog will have a period, and does he need to get tampons? Does he need to get pads?
Okay.
What does he need to do to prepare for the situation? He's a single guy.
Yeah.
He doesn't have any sisters. Really can't talk to any females about this. So he's come to you.
Well, Ahmad, first I would say there is not a question you can ask your veterinarian that they have not already heard. Don't be too embarrassed. Don't be afraid to ask your veterinarian these questions. And yes, dogs do menstruate, but no, you really don't. Do not go buy any human products whatsoever. Your dog does not need any feminine hygiene products. It's very natural for your dog. What I would suggest you do is looking at alternatives to spaying, meaning not a hysterectomy, but a desex type. I don't know what's available in Pakistan, so you are going to have to talk to your veterinarian. And I wish I knew more about what's available in Pakistan, but if you can spay your dog prior, I mean, they may go through heat, it can happen as early as 6 months of age in some dogs. It really depends on the dog. Breed can play a factor, health can play a factor, but it can happen pretty soon, in up to a year of age. Sometimes it can take up to a year of age. So I wouldn't put off this conversation with your vet too much longer, because you want to have that conversation about getting your dog spayed, or an alternative to spaying, like a desex procedure, depending on what's available where you reside in Pakistan. I wish I knew more about what's available there, but your veterinarian can tell you. And then that way you don't have to worry about your dog ever going into heat. If your dog does go into heat before you take your dog to the vet and ask these questions, which, please, they are not to your vet. These are not uncomfortable questions, okay? They get these questions all the time, and they are well versed in how to answer you on these questions. If your dog does go into heat, though, before you get your dog back into the veterinarian, just wait until that heat cycle is over. Sometimes heat cycles can come back to back, so I would recommend getting your dog in right away and talking to your veterinarian about this. Again, it's not going to be uncomfortable for them, I promise.
All right, that's a very good answer, and that, I understand, that's a tough question to ask, especially if you're a single guy and you don't have any females around, but you've answered it well. I think that really answers it well for them. Now, my next question here comes from Tina.
Tina.
And she is in Miami, Florida.
Okay.
And she has an embarrassment problem.
Oh.
And here's the embarrassment problem. She has friends over to her house.
Okay.
Nice dinner parties, everything. Her dog is so gassy and farts so much around everybody, she says she can't keep blaming other people. It is the dog. So what does she do to prevent her dog from, I don't know, farting all the time, I guess?
Okay, I totally understand why that one is uncomfortable to ask, but thank you, Tina, for asking it. If your dog is that gassy, there's something not going on well in your dog's gut. And I would venture to say your dog is eating a kibble diet. So that would be the very first thing I would look at, is transitioning your dog to a balanced fresh food diet. Again, I have talked about this over and over and over on this channel, so I will link to other videos in the description where you can look into this a bit further. I would also suggest that you join the group. There's a link in the description to join the group, join the family. And in the group, I have tons of files that are just free to you, tons of information. One of those files, actually I think two of those files, talks about diet, and it gives a list of some of the best raw food brands that are commercially available that I recommend to people. And these are going to be balanced fresh food, raw diets. I would definitely recommend checking into these and transitioning your dog to a better food, a more nutritious food. And I think you'll see a big difference in your dog's gut health. We know that about 80% of our immune system is in our gut. So if you're seeing severe signs, such as the amount of gas that your dog is having, we know there's something not right in your dog's gut. Imagine what that is doing to your dog's immune system. While having gas is embarrassing, what's actually going on inside of your dog's body is not so embarrassing. It can be pretty detrimental in the long run. So I would say, let's get your dog transitioned to a balanced fresh food diet. Again, there are tons of commercially available brands. That there are some that are not so good, and there are some that are really amazing, which is why I do recommend going ahead and joining the group, getting access to those files, which are completely free. Joining the group is free to you. Accessing the files in the group is completely free to you. Go ahead and do that and start checking out what's available in your area. And you and your dog are going to be much happier for it.
Wow, that is really helpful. And I gotta admit, these have been some uncomfortable questions. But you know what? We've got to handle all these things. I think it all has to do with the health of our pet. And if the pet's healthy and happy, I guess they're going to have a better relationship. Is that true?
Absolutely.
Now, if people have more questions, they want to ask you more things, what other resources, or how can they ask you directly some of these questions? And would you actually do a video for somebody on one of these questions?
I do videos to answer your questions all the time. That's what this video is. So if you ask me a question and you want me to, absolutely, I will answer it on a video just like this. I can answer you directly as well as answering it on a video. The best ways to get your questions answered, I just talked about joining the group, so I won't go through that again, but the link is in the description. Joining the group is one of the best ways to get your questions answered, but you can always post in the comments below this video as well. And I definitely recommend you do that, because I can not only answer the comment, but I can further answer the question in one of these videos. All right, guys, if you haven't already, look right down there at that subscribe button. If it is red, go ahead and click it and turn it gray. When you do that, a bell will appear like this. Click the bell, select all notifications. That way YouTube can notify you every time I post a new video. And what's that gonna do for you? That's going to save you so much time. So you're not gonna have to go around searching on YouTube for whatever videos I have done since the last time you came on. YouTube is gonna be able to just send you a notification. Hey, Jessica just posted this video. You can click on it and watch it right then and there. Also, give this video a thumbs up. Let me know you liked it. Let YouTube know you liked it. It's the best compliment you can give, and I would really appreciate that. All right, guys, thank you so much for joining me in this video. I always love doing these videos for you, but to keep doing them, you do have to keep asking questions. So, like I said, join the group, ask questions, post your questions in the comments below. I definitely need those questions from you so I can keep doing these videos.
Do me a favor. If you like this video, put below, I like it, I love it, it's the best.
And do me a favor, if you do like this video, go ahead and comment below, I like it, I love it, it's the best. All right, guys, I'm gonna go ahead and end this video. Again, thank you so much for watching. I can't tell you how much I appreciate you. Yes, you, for watching this video and visiting with me on YouTube. I can't wait to see you in our next video. Hey, thanks for watching. Make sure to give this video a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel so you never miss another video.